It is a spectacular sight. You got to work to get to, but I'm telling you why. This is an incredible place. It doesn't even look real, does it?
...2,600-acre facility. How unbelievable is this? He's still staying. It's almost like some type of Stonehenge. They did make a movie out here. And the stairs were actually left to this house. This was a completed home, in case people wonder. This was a completed home. And the stairs, which were in the front, actually were donated to a college. I'll try to find a picture of that. But, you know, you're in the middle of, I mean, nowhere. And it's so unbelievably cool that this, even the columns still exist. This is definitely worth the trip alone. It's breathtaking. These mighty columns at the Windsor Mansion stand like a silent sentinel, protecting not only its heritage, but the heritage of the area. Windsor Mansion was one of the largest plantation homes ever built anywhere in the South, at over 17,000 square feet and 25 rooms. The home was built by Smith Coffee Daniell II, a wealthy planter. In 1849, he would wed his cousin, Catherine Freeland. They would have seven children, three of whom would survive adulthood. The couple started construction of the home in 1859 on their 2,600-acre plantation that overlooked the Mississippi River. Basic structure was built by slaves, and bricks were fired on the plantation grounds. In 1849, he married his cousin, Catherine Freeland. The couple had seven children, three of whom would survive to adulthood. The structure overlooked the Mississippi River and is also featured in Mark Twain's book when he was a riverboat pilot. England craftsmen were brought in and the couple spared no expense on this elaborate home. 29 fluted columns were 45 feet tall. Estimated cost of this home was over $175,000. The home was completed in 1861, but regrettably Daniell passed away only weeks before the house was completed. It would not be long till General Ulysses S. Grant's campaign of Vicksburg would bring the Civil War to the plantation. The Confederate soldiers used the house as a lookout over the Mississippi River. During the Battle of Port Gibson, this was used as a hospital for both sides. The Union Army came to burn the plantation. Catherine begged, saying that we had helped both sides during the war, and the Union soldiers spared the plantation, but its heyday was over. Regrettably, there are no pictures of the home, but a Union soldier actually drew a picture of the house as he remembered it. Hard times fell on the household and they ended up having to sell the land around the mansion and a lot of the holdings. Regrettably, tragedy would strike again some 25 years later on February 17, 1890, when smoke was seen over the mansion. A worker carelessly tossed a cigarette,
Windsor,
and the mansion burned to the ground.
What an incredible place. It was worth the drive out here. This was a drive. We were absolutely in the middle of nowhere. But this was worth every bit. Windsor Ruins. We're going to go with this fast. Made by Smith Coffee Daniell II, successful cotton planter. He owned 21,000 acres. Died in April of 1861, only weeks after getting ready to have this done. It has 23 rooms, and it survived the Civil War, but an accidental fire in February of 1890, all was lost. And this was the house right here.